I read a verse a few moments ago where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of something very important, and I'm sure most of us would know this off by heart. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ I have not created mankind or jinnkind except that they worship me. مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقَ I do not want from them any sustenance. In fact, Allah is the provider. Whatever I have, whatever you have, is only and solely from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So He is the provider, He is the granter, He is the one in absolute control, and He does not want sustenance from us. In fact, if we worship Him, we may worship Him through the very sustenance that He has provided us. He gave us life, He gave us health, He gave us wealth. Through the life, the health, and the wealth that He has given us, He expects us to worship Him for our benefit, not for His. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ أَنْتُمُ الْفُقَرَاءُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ هُوَ الْغَنِيُّ الْحَمِيدُ إِنْ يَشَأْ يُذْهِبْكُمْ وَيَأْتِ بِخَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ وَمَا ذَٰلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ بِعَزِيزٍ O people, you are the ones who are in absolute need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah is totally independent from you. He does not need you for anything whatsoever. If He wants, He can delete you and replace you with others. And that is not difficult at all for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the powerful verses of the Quran. He can delete me and He can delete you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says very clearly that He has deleted previous nations. The verses I read at the beginning of this talk where Allah speaks about Ad and Thamud and Fir'aun and the others who were much more powerful than I am and you are. They had lots of wealth. Some of the people of Fir'aun, such as a man known as Qarun, he had so much wealth that the keys to the treasures of his wealth were so heavy for even a group of strong men to carry. Imagine, not the treasures, only the keys to the treasures of his wealth. وَآتَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْكُنُوزِ مَا إِنَّ مَفَاتِحَهُ لَتَنُوءُ بِالْعُصْبَةِ أُولِي الْقُوَّةِ We gave him so much treasures that the keys of those treasures were difficult to be carried by a group of strong men. Subhanallah. Isn't that more than what I have and you have? Today we have a little card, and that card is what we're worth. Subhanallah. Perhaps it says Visa on there, or it might be saying something else, but that's what we're worth. One little plastic piece. Allah protect us. They were given much wealth, and Allah says we deleted them. Qarun himself was made to be eaten by the earth in a way that there was no remnants. What happened to the people of Thamud, the people of Ad? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks of Fir'aun and his cronies. فَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِهِ Each one of them, we punished them because of their sins. They had sins and they did not turn. We have a gift of istighfar. Istighfar meaning to turn to Allah. Ask Allah's forgiveness, He will forgive you. We always say four conditions of repentance. Admit the sin, regret it, ask Allah to forgive you and promise not to do it again. Admit your sin, regret it, ask Allah to forgive you and promise not to do it again. Your sin is deleted, wiped out, formatted, mashallah. You have a new hard drive. So it's not even traceable. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this beautiful IT city for us to give examples that will really be befitting for the mindset and the brain level of those whom I'm seated in front of. Or should I say, I'm standing in front of. Look at how I've become. I don't even know whether I'm standing or sitting. Mashallah. Beloved brothers and sisters, what is the focus? What should be in front of my eyes? Before we speak of whether or not we are losing focus, we need to ask ourselves, what is it that we are meant to be focused upon? We can answer that in many ways, but ultimately our focus is the pleasure of Allah, and Jannah is a result. So I am meant to be focused upon paradise. I am meant to be focused upon preparing for the day I meet my Maker. Aren't you excited about meeting your Maker? Subhanallah. I'm going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so are you. I want to see him, don't you? Subhanallah. Today I had people saying, we can't believe that we're seeing you in person. I am no big deal, believe me. You might get so fed up of what, you know, of seeing me that you might think, okay, I don't want to see him. But with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my Maker and yours, imagine if we were to see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of judgment. What an honor. Don't I want to see him? Well, prepare for that day. Focus on it, subhanallah. But more important than that is to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah grant us the intercession of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of Qiyamah and on the day of judgment. May Allah open our doors and grant us a sip from the pond of Kawthar. Remember, my brothers and sisters, I should be focused in my life upon paradise. My eyes should be set on it completely. Whatever I do, every single day, I must ask myself, will this earn me paradise? If it does, it will earn you the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the people of Jannah get to Jannah, paradise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask them, did you find what you were promised to be true? They will say, yes indeed. Anything you want, subhanallah. Allah says, لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ. They will have whatever they wish for in paradise. And we have something extra to give them. We have something more to give them. What is the explanation of this extra? The muhaddithin or mufassireen and the ulama and the sahaba radiallahu anhum explain it. They say it is the gift of looking at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which will be a gift for those who enter paradise. Yes, the hadith says, ma minkum min ahadin illa sayukallimuhu rabbuhu laysa baynahu wa baynahu turjuman. Every single one of you will speak to your Maker without a middleman, without an interpreter, without someone in the middle to explain to you what is being said. But that is speaking. What about looking? As for looking, it's a gift of the people who go into Jannah. You want to see your Maker? So do I. I'm intrigued by his creation. What about the one who made it? Today we look at a motor vehicle. We look at the new mobile phones. Have you seen the iPhone 6? Wow. Well, I haven't. I'm waiting for it. Have you seen, what can I say? The S4, have you seen it? Samsung, mashallah. Have you seen it? They told me, someone tried to tell me, you know, Samsung, I don't know why they call it that. You know, perhaps it's some Japanese term or Korean term or whatever it is. I said, no, very simple. There was a man known as Sam. He passed away, but when he was alive, he used to sing. Now it's past tense, so they say Samsung. May Allah protect us. May he keep us from amongst those who recite, inshallah. May Allah open our doors, really. So whether it is Sam sung or didn't sing, we don't mind. The reality is we want our eyes fixed, not on the next iPhone to come out or the next Android to come out or HTC to come out. Our eyes should be fixed on Jannah. Whatever I see in this world, you see a good looking person, mashallah. Your eyes should be focused on the Maker of that person more than anything else. You see something brilliant that soothes the eyes, the sceneries in Bangalore, beautiful sceneries which you take for granted, but people like myself would notice because we come from somewhere else. Subhanallah. If you see those sceneries immediately, instead of just saying, wow, you know, wow, that's the word today, W-O-W, capital. And sometimes to make it sound big, they put mad. You know what's a mad? They want to stretch the word as though it's Quran. So they will put W and O's from here to the door, subhanallah. And then another W at the door. And that means I'm very intrigued. We say, MashaAllah, as Muslimin. And we say, if he could create such a beautiful scene, I wonder what he must be looking like. La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us realize what we should be focusing on. So as I say, the maker, I want to meet him, I want to talk to him, and I want to be close to him. Don't you want to be close to him? Today, if you knew a huge celebrity on the globe and they could phone you, call you, speak to you, if you were to say, I'm very close to this person, sometimes it may be a lie because a lot of people tell lies. And even if we are telling the truth, people think we are lying. So mashallah, we have a problem in the dunya. But when you're close to Allah and when He declares that He is close to you, what more do you want? What more can I ask for? When Allah says, I am close to you, imagine what He told Ibrahim alayhi salam. He says to us, وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. Allah has taken Ibrahim as a very close friend. Khalil al-Khullah, أعلى مراتب المحبة. One of the highest levels of love is, or should I say, friendship, closeness, is known as al-Khullah. You are very close, bosom buddies, as we would say. Imagine if someone says that they are so close to you, and yet they are people whom no one ever sees. If they were to declare that they know you, may Allah protect us. It's easy for every one of us to say, we know that person and this person, but for them to say they know you, that is what they say is the speech we want to hear. So for us to say we are close to Allah is one thing, and for Allah to say, I am close to this worshipper, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. That is where we should be focused. In this world, people will let you down. Your husband will let you down. Your wife will let you down. Your children will let you down. The people around you will let you down. Your brothers and sisters will let you down. Your parents may let you down. Your children may let you down. Your maker will never ever let you down. Allahu Akbar. Never ever let you down. So if you give your heart and your mind away to someone you love, they may let you down. But if you give it away to Allah, He will never let you down. Subhanallah.